1990s was an eventful decade for QPR. The dawn of the Premier League, a fifth place finish before relegation in 96, and then the rather forgettable Steve Slade years. Now the team did have some great players during the decade, and this video will look at which player scored the most goals in both league and cup matches for Rangers during the 90s. In 10th place with 21 goals is Trevor Sinclair. Now Trevor scored 16 league goals for QPR and 5 in cup competitions across his 5 years at the club. He joined QPR from Blackpool in August 1993, replacing Andy Sinton, and he quickly made the step up to the Premier League with an impressive first season, helping the club to a top half finish with 4 goals and 6 assists. He was more known for his creativity than goal scoring, but finished the season strongly with these 2 goals in a win at Tottenham. He had his best goal scoring season in the 94-95 season, grabbing 5 goals, including this brilliant one against West Ham, which helped him win a call up to the England under 21 squad, where he won 14 caps, scoring 5 goals for his country. In October 1995, he won the Premier League Player of the Month award and became the club's key player with some superb displays. Although the season ended in heartbreak with the club relegated from the top flight, Sinclair's reputation was starting to grow. Now much was expected of Sinclair in the second tier, and he produced some moments of real quality, including these goals against Charlton and Manchester City. Of course, he is best known for this goal in the FA Cup against Barnsley, which is still regarded as one of the greatest FA Cup goals ever scored. It won the BBC Match of the Day Goal of the Season award that season. He was regularly linked with moves away from QPR, but stayed at Rangers until February 1998, when he was sold to West Ham in a deal that was more highway robbery than football transfer. Sinclair went on to have a great career at West Ham and later his boyhood club Man City, whilst also winning 12 caps for England, which included some impressive displays in the 2002 World Cup. In 9th place, with 23 goals, is Gary Penrice. Now Penrice scored 20 league goals and 3 in cup competitions during his time with the club. He began his career at Bristol Rovers and played alongside school friend Ian Holloway during his 5 years at the club, before a move to Watford and later Aston Villa. He joined QPR in November 1991 to be reunited with his former boss Jerry Francis, but he had a slow start at Rangers as he recovered from a broken leg and struggled to get into the team, scoring just 3 goals in his first season. He quickly became an important player for Rangers in the 92-93 season, as he scored 7 League and Cup goals, including this double against Tottenham in a 4-1 win. Injury affected him as he missed much of the second half of the season, but he returned in good form in the 93-94 season, with his best goal return, scoring 8 League goals and helping the club to another top half finish. He scored his final goal for QPR in a 2-1 win over Aston Villa before leaving to rejoin Watford in November 1995. After retiring as a player, he returned to the club as a coach under Ian Holloway in 2002 before moving into scouting at Stoke, Everton and Leicester before returning to Rangers as a scout in 2016. In 8th place with 24 goals, we have Danny Diccio. Now Danny scored 24 goals for QPR, with 21 in the league and 3 in cup competitions. He came through the ranks at Rangers, impressing in the youth team and reserves before getting his first taste of league football on loan at Barnet. He made his debut for the first team against Aston Villa in 1994, where he also scored his first goal in a 2-0 win. Diccio made 4 starts that season with 5 appearances from the bench, but he managed to score 3 goals for the club, and after the departure of Les Ferdinand, he was elevated to be the main striker in the 95-96 season. That proved to be his best goal scoring season for the club, scoring 10 league goals in just 22 starts, including this brilliant double against Newcastle, He also grabbed key goals in wins over Bolton, Southampton and Leeds, but he couldn't prevent the club being relegated. He started the 96-97 season well, scoring this brilliant goal against Wolves, but he struggled for consistency in what became a frustrating season for him. He finished the season with 7 goals and scored in his final home appearance before moving to Sampdoria. Diccio went on to have a good career playing for Sunderland and West Brom in the top flight before ending his career in America. Still affectionately known as the Hammersmith Horse, Diccio is 8th in the list of top QPR goalscorers of the 1990s. In 7th place, also with 24 goals, but one more league goal, is John Spencer. Now Spencer had an explosive time at QPR. He was at the club for just over a year, but scored 22 league and 2 cup goals. Spencer had already enjoyed a good career at Chelsea, scoring 36 goals in the top flight, and winning 14 caps for Scotland, where he appeared at Euro 96. He joined QPR in November 96 for £2.5 million and announced himself to the QPR fans by scoring on his debut at Reading in front of a packed away end. His form was blistering for Rangers, scoring 9 goals in his first 10 games, including this perfect hat-trick against Barnsley with a left-foot finish, a header, and finishing off with a right-footed finish. He had an incredible knack of scoring goals from what looked like impossible angles. But one of his best moments came in the memorable match at Port Vale, where QPR trailed 4-1 with just 5 minutes remaining. The team made a remarkable comeback, with Spencer scoring this goal to make it 4-all deep into injury time, and he was held aloft by the Rangers fans. He ended the season with 17 goals in 25 appearances as the team just missed out on the playoffs. His second season at the club didn't go as well, but he still scored another 5 goals in a struggling side before moving to Everton in January 1998. In 6th place we have the club's first £1 million player, Roy Wegerle, who scored 31 goals for Rangers, 29 in the league and 2 in cup competitions. Now Wegerle began his career in America for the Tampa Bay Rowdies, where he was coached by QPR legend Rodney Marsh. In 1986, Marsh tried to get Wegerle a move to England, with QPR turning down the chance to take him, so he ended up at Chelsea before a move to Luton, where his career took off. QPR made their move for him in December 1989, paying £1 million for the forward, and he quickly established himself as a real fan's favourite, wearing that number 10 shirt. He mesmerised QPR fans on his home debut with a brilliant performance against Coventry, before scoring his first goal for the club in an FA Cup tie with Cardiff. He scored 8 goals in the second half of that season, but his performances helped him really stand out as the team finished the season well and reached the quarterfinals of the FA Cup. This brilliant goal against Arsenal showed what he was capable of. The 1990-91 season was his best for QPR. He started the season well and was the only QPR player to score in the first 4 games of the season, which included this winner against Chelsea. He scored these 2 quality goals against his former side Luton as Rangers ran riot Loftus Road. And the goals continued to flow, with 9 in his first 10 games of that season. But it was the away game at Leeds where he was elevated to club legend status with this unbelievable individual goal to help the team come from 2-0 down to win 3-2. In the second half of the season, he formed an impressive partnership with Les Ferdinand, and he was on the score sheet in his famous 3-1 win at Anfield. He finished that season as top goal scorer with 19 league and cup goals. Now things didn't seem to work out for him after Jerry Francis arrived at the club, but despite that he still scored some excellent goals, including this one in a 2-2 draw at Manchester City. Wegerle left the club to join Blackburn in March 1992, with the money rumoured to have been used to build the Roy Wegerle Memorial Staircase in the South Africa Road Stand. Wegerle went on to win promotion to the Premier League with Blackburn, before spells at Coventry and then back in America with DC United. His 31 goals at QPR only tell half the story of an incredibly skillful and graceful player who, when on top of his game, would get the fans off their seats. Into the top five now, and we've got a joint fourth place here with two players each on 32 goals. Now we'll start with Gavin Peacock, who scored 27 league and 5 cup goals during the 1990s. Now Peacock started his career at Rangers before he moved to 3rd Division Gillingham in 1987. He was signed by Harry Redknapp for Bournemouth in 1989 before a move to former QPR manager Jim Smith at Newcastle United. It was there that he made a real name for himself, helping Newcastle to promotion in 1992 before a move to Chelsea. Peacock returned to QPR in 1996 in a bid to help Rangers back to the Premier League. And he made a good start, scoring his first goal in a 2-0 win at Oldham. He proved to be a key part of the team, adding 5 goals from midfield as we pushed for the playoffs. Peacock became a regular in the QPR team during a difficult few years for the club, but he was always one of our most reliable players during that period. In the 1997-98 season, he had his best goal scoring return, scoring 10 league and cup goals, before adding another 8 goals in the following season, as Rangers narrowly avoided relegation. This late goal to seal a win over West Brom played a massive part in the team staying up that season. He began the 1999-2000 season scoring in the first 5 games, and ended the 90s with 32 goals in total for QPR. He stayed at QPR until 2002, before having a testimonial game against Chelsea in May 2003. Also in joint fourth place, we have another member of the Allen family, with Bradley Allen scoring 32 goals for the club, 27 in the league and 5 in the cup. Now Bradley came through the youth setup at QPR, making his debut for the club under Don Howe in 1990. He scored his first goal for Rangers that same season, getting the winner against Aston Villa. But he found breaking into the team harder the following season, as he struggled with injuries, but he impressed towards the end of that season, scoring this goal in a 4-1 win over Leeds United. He also added a double against West Ham, including this goal, eerily similar to one his brother Clive scored for QPR years earlier. Now the 1992-93 season proved to be his best goal scoring one for QPR. He missed the start of the season but was soon back scoring goals, getting 11 across the season. Now Bradley arguably played his best football for QPR in the 93-94 season, before injury ended his season around Christmas. He opened the scoring for QPR at Old Trafford during a prolific run for him, as he scored 10 goals in just 7 games, including 2 hat-tricks in wins over Barnet in the League Cup and away at Everton in the Premier League. In his final few years at the club, he struggled to hold down a place in the team, and he left to join Charlton in 1996. Into the top three, and in third place we have the man with a magic hat, Kevin Gallen, with 39 goals for QPR, 35 in the league and 4 in cup competitions. Now Gallen would end up having another spell at Rangers in the noughties, but he burst onto the scene at QPR during the 1990s. Gallen was well known to QPR fans after breaking Jimmy Greaves' goal scoring record, scoring 71 goals in a season and over 150 goals during his 2 years with the under-18s. He also won the European Under-18s tournament with England in 1993 alongside Robbie Fowler, Sol Campbell and Paul Scholes before making his first team debut for QPR at Old Trafford in August 1994. Gallen had a goal disallowed but scored on his home debut days later, with expectations huge around him. The goals didn't come straight away though in the first team, and he was in and out of the side a bit before a change of manager saw Ray Wilkins take over, and Gallen eventually became first choice alongside Les Ferdinand. The pair of them worked brilliantly together, both scoring goals individually, but as a pair creating goals for each other. They remained third in the Premier League for the most goal combinations in a season with 11 goals. Gallen assisted 7 of these and ended his first season with 12 league and cup goals. His most famous goal that season came on my 19th birthday when he rose to head home the winner against Chelsea, which of course began the famous magic hat chant. In the 1995-96 season, like most of the team, he struggled to find his best form again, as the team relegated. But he finished the season quite well, scoring 4 goals in the last 6 games of that season as he battled to stay up. This double against West Ham meant he finished the season with a respectable 9 League and Cup goals. He began the following season on fire, scoring 3 goals in his first 2 starts. But this winner at Portsmouth proved to be costly as he suffered a cruciate knee ligament injury which ended his season. Gallen faced a difficult few years as he struggled to recover from the injury, but remained a hugely popular player at Rangers and began to return to his best in the 97-98 season, scoring some vital goals towards the end of that season which helped keep the club up. He adapted his game as more of a hold-up player, but was still scoring goals, added another 8 goals in the 98-99 season, including this great finish against Bolton. He ended the 90s with 39 goals for the club, but after leaving to join Huddersfield in the summer of 2000, he would return for a great second spell with the club in 2001, where he helped the club to promotion and went on to score 97 goals for the club across his career. In second place, perhaps a surprise, we have the excellent Simon Barker, who scored 40 goals for QPR in the 90s, 32 in the league and 8 in cup competitions. Now Barker joined QPR from Blackburn in 1988 and spent 10 years at the club, playing across the Rangers midfield. Now the goals didn't come easily at first for Barker, scoring just 1 in his first season in a 4-1 win at Southampton, but he soon proved to be a great all-round player for the team. He had a great range of passing and was a real box-to-box midfield player, playing some of his best football in the 89-90 season. He scored 5 goals and had a great second half to that season, which almost got him on the plane for the 1990 World Cup. In the FA Cup, he scored this brilliant goal to earn a replay with Liverpool in the quarter-final, as he burst into the box with a great finish. A broken leg cost him his place in the World Cup and ended his season, but he returned to the QPR side the following season, helping the team to a mid-table finish. His best goal-scoring seasons came when he scored 8 goals in both the 91-92 and the 93-94 seasons. That 91-92 season was a big one for Barker, as he really established himself in the QPR midfield, scoring some vital goals to get a first win for Gerry Francis and also a first home win for the new manager. Now during the Premier League years, Barker continued to contribute with some fine performances and some fine goals as well. This chipped effort away at Sheffield Wednesday remains my favourite of his 40 goals for the club, a finish of pure skill and elegance. After the club was relegated, Barker remained an important member of the first team, still adding goals from midfield until he left the club in 1998. But Barker was an excellent midfield player for us, and is second on the list for top goal scorers of the 1990s. So to first place, and no real surprise with this one. He remains one of the best forwards in the club's history, and with 78 league and 10 cup goals in the 90s, Les Ferdinand is the clear winner here. Now Ferdinand began the 90s looking like he was going to leave the club after struggling to break into the first team under Don Howe. But an injury to Roy Wegerle saw him get his chance in 1991, and he grabbed it with both hands, scoring twice at Luton, including this superb solo goal to win it late on. Ferdinand scored 7 goals in 7 games to help move QPR away from the relegation zone and to mid-table safety before injury ended his season prematurely. This diving header against Manchester City showed what he was all about. Great awareness to find David Bardsley, great pace to get into the box, and then a superb diving header to finish it off. A change of manager saw a change of fortune for Ferdinand, as Jerry Francis gave Ferdinand a new sense of belief and confidence. Although it didn't happen straight away, with injury seeing him miss the first half of that season. He sprang into life around March, scoring a near replica of his goal against Man City in a 4-0 win, and he finished the season strongly, scoring 7 goals in the final 11 games of that season, including this late winner against Luton. Ferdinand had now established himself as the main striker at QPR, and in the 92-93 season he got off to a great start, with 3 goals in his first 3 games in what would be a massive season for him. QPR finished 5th and Ferdinand played a huge part in that, scoring 24 League and Cup goals. That form continued and Ferdinand netted 18 goals in the 93-94 season and a career best at QPR of 26 goals in the 1994-95 season. Ferdinand scored all sorts of goals, from amazing solo efforts to long-range shots, tap-ins, and of course his incredible leap, which saw him score so many headers. Ferdinand had everything you'd want from a striker and won 7 of his 17 England caps whilst at QPR, scoring 3 of his 5 goals for his country during his time in Shepherd's Bush. Overall, he scored 90 goals for QPR, with 88 of them coming in the 90s. He left QPR to join Newcastle for £6 million in 1995 and went on to win the PFA Player of the Year award in 96 before winning the League Cup at Spurs. After retiring, Ferdinand returned to QPR in 2015 as the club's director of football. So there you have it, the top 10 QPR goal scorers of the 1990s. So in 10th place, we've got Trevor Sinclair with 21 goals. Then in 9th place, Gary Penrice with 23. Danny Diccio and John Spencer both had 24 goals. And then we have Roy Wegerle with 31 goals. In joint 4th place, we have Bradley Allen and Gavin Peacock both on 32 goals. And in 3rd place, Kevin Gallen with 39 goals. Simon Barker is in 2nd with 40 goals in the 90s, but way out in front is Les Ferdinand with 88 goals. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give us a like and subscribe to the channel for more QPR content. Come on, you Rs!